My name is Eric Duoss. I'm a research engineer here at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory. I work on new additive manufacturing or 3D printing technologies, specifically developing new materials for those processes for a wide range of end applications. 3D printing or additive manufacturing is really powerful because it gives you the possibility of controlling now very precisely composition and structure. And often you can do that at the microscales or even nanoscales now. One example that we've been developing here at Lawrence Livermore are mechanical energy absorbing materials. These are things that will resist an impact. One could think about in the context of a smartphone, drops and cracks due to drops. Could you design a better mechanical energy absorbing material to cushion that impact? One of the things that we're very interested in pursuing with three-dimensional printing is energy storage. For example, lithium ion batteries for electrochemical energy storage. This is just a mock-up, and you can start to print these active materials. In this case, you might have the red material be a cathode, the blue material be an anode, and you can better distribute them in space as opposed to planar stack-ups or films of active materials, which are typically what batteries are composed of. In a normal battery, the layers are thicker, so it can store more energy, but it can't charge and discharge as quickly. But now if you architect them in three dimensions, you can get the best of both worlds. In traditional smartphones, there are a lot of rare earths, critical materials that often they'll end up in a landfill. There's more and more efforts to recover those, but that in and of itself causes problems. It's very laborious. Often these materials are toxic. So with carbon-based electrodes, such as these graphene aerogels, one can think about really limiting the environmental impact, especially when it comes to smartphones, simply because it's carbon and it has typically very benign impact to the environment. There is increasing interest in this emerging technologies, and I think you're going to start to see 3D printed elements show up in smartphone technology very, very soon.